about the Pythagoras theorem, what it states here, you know that the Pythagoras theorem is applicable for the right angle triangle, and what it states here, if you consider any right angle triangle, you know that here the longest side in a triangle we call it as an hypotenuse. So what it states here, in a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other side. We have solved so many problems by using this Pythagoras theorem, but you don't know how to prove this theorem. Now in this class we are going to prove that theorem. So let us write it here, A, B, C. So you know what is the Pythagoras theorem. So write it here, in a right angle triangle, is equal to sum of the squares of other two sides. This is what the Pythagoras theorem, what it states here, in a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. So what we need to prove here? We need to prove here AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Right? This is what we need to prove here. Now, here for this we need one construction. We need to draw here one perpendicular line from the right angle. In this triangle, where is the right angle? At B. So at this point, at this vertex, you need to draw here one perpendicular line to the hypotenuse. So let us draw here one perpendicular line. So we have drawn here one perpendicular line. This is our construction. Now you need to prove here AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So let us see here in the right hand side what is there here. AB square is there. Here you can observe that square is there. Now you need to choose two triangles such a way that the base should be 2 times AB, right? So if you consider here, let us consider this as some x, right? Now if you consider here in triangle ABX, you can observe that here AB is there, right? So we got it here, 1 AB. Now let us see here in which triangle you can consider so that you have the side as AB. Now if you consider the bigger triangle ABC, similarly you have here the side AB, right? Now if you multiply these two, you will get here AB square. So that is what we are going to do now. So what we need to do here first, you need to check it here in the right hand side. You can observe that AB square is there. So you need to choose two triangles in such a way that AB should be there. So what are those triangles? You can observe here triangle ABX. What is the triangle? ABX. And you can choose the bigger triangle, which is ABC. Now if we can prove these two triangles are similar, then we will got one equation. Let us prove here these two triangles are similar. This theorem only we have proved. Based on this concept we will solve this one. So let us see here how to prove these two triangles are similar. Now in the smaller triangle, if you consider this smaller triangle, where is the right angle? Angle X is the right angle. So here in the smaller triangle, angle X is the right angle, and in the bigger triangle, angle B is the right angle. So you can equate here angle AXB is equal to angle B, right? Because both are equal to 90 degrees. Now again, if you consider here this smaller triangle ABX, here not here AB square. For that reason, we have considered two triangles such that where AB is the AB should be there. So we have considered triangle ABX here AB is there, and we have considered triangle ABC here AB is there, and we have proved here these two triangles are similar. Now we know that if these two triangles are similar, their corresponding sides are proportional. From that we will get AB by AC is equal to AX by AB. Let us consider now cross multiply these two. AB into AB, which is AB square, is equal to AC into AX. This is what we got. Let us consider this as equation 1. Again, I will write the proof of this one. So, what we got it here? We got one equation, which is AB square is equal to AC into AX. Okay? Let us leave that one like that. Now, here again, if you can see here in the right hand side, here BC square is there. That means here you need to choose two triangles such that BC should be there. What are those triangles? Let us see here. You can consider here in triangle BCX, BC is there, right? So you can choose the triangle BCX. And similarly, if you consider the bigger triangle, here BC is there. So you can choose here one more triangle ABC. Again, we need to prove here these two triangles are similar, so that you can take their corresponding sides are proportional. So here, in this triangle, where is the right angle? Angle X is equal to 90 degrees, because by our construction. So here, you got it here, angle BXC is equal to 90. And in the bigger triangle, angle B is 90 degrees. So you know that this angle is equal to this angle. Why? Because these two are equal to 90 degrees. Now let us see what is the common angle in these two triangles. You can consider that here angle C is there, and similarly if you consider the bigger triangle, again angle C is there. So angle C is the common angle to both of these triangles. So let us write it here, angle C is equal to angle C. Now you can apply here angle-angle similarity. So by angle-angle similarity, you can say that these two triangles are similar. So how you can write? You can write it.
You will get BC square is equal to
equations 1 and 2. So I write what you are getting here. AB square plus BC square is equal to AC into AX plus AC into CX. This we have added. So that what we got it here. In the right hand side you can take it here AC common. So that you will get here AX plus CX. But what is AX plus CX, which is nothing but AC. You got it here AC square and here AB square plus BC square. This is what we need to prove. Okay. This is the proof of the Pythagoras theorem. So what it states? In a right hand triangle, the hypotenuse square is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. And in the next session, we are going to do the converse of this statement. From this session is